The most disturbing things caught on doorbell cameras.
This first video was captured in the middle of the night at an apartment complex in Toledo. Doorbell footage shows a man knocking on the front door with what looks like a firearm in his waistband.
Oh, damn, now, he got a gun?
The owner of the apartment didn't recognize the man, so she would question who it was. The unknown man would simply respond with, "It's me." The homeowner would then further question his response, but rather than clarifying, he would simply give a way through the front door.
Saying, "It's me," imagine hearing that at your door. "It's me." Nah, who is it? "It's me." Who? Oh, you can see the firearm in his pants too. Look, he's literally holding on to it. Now this is a robbery attempt right here.
However, it would not be enough to get the home order to open it.
Okay.
So you would ultimately walk off.
That's good.
Disturbingly, as he does so, a second man pops up from a nearby dumpster and also walks off.
Ah. Where is it? Oh my gosh. That
is this wouldn't be the end of it.
So disturbing.
The two would then walk around to the back door, where they would attempt to pick its
lock. It doesn't end.
The police were called, and when they arrived, the two were gone. Fortunately, unsuccessful in getting the door open. It's not 100% clear what the two-minute plan. The almost empty-looking backpack at the first guy suggests they had planned to rob the place.
Yeah, I was about to say.
But it's also possible they had much worse intentions. The two of them have yet to be identified by police.
Oh my, that is terrifying. That is literally terrifying. Like, yeah, like ghosts and like the paranormal is really scary, but what's even more scary than that is like home invasions and stuff like that. That is what is scary, because that stuff is actually like 100% true and could literally happen to anybody. Paranormal, you know, there's skeptics. Some people, yeah, it could happen. Some people, no, you know, paranormal's not real. But home invasions are real. Oh, it's so scary.
The homeowner in Texas would wake up one morning to find the gate into his backyard wide open.
Ooh.
Curious, the man would review the cameras he had around his house. And this is the sign he was
met with. You've got to be kidding me. A clown with a knife, yo.
A man holding a knife and in a clown costume, complete with the suit and mask, casually walks around the property, looking inside the house and testing all the doors.
That's horrific. Even just looking at your phone and seeing that on the security camera. Nah. Trying the doors and everything. Dude, people are crazy.
This will, of course, take place in 2016, during that sort of killer clown craze that went on for a few months. Looking back, most people that participated in that were most likely just having fun trying to scare people.
This guy doesn't look like he's just having fun.
But there's no denying that others took advantage of the situation, genuinely attempting some pretty horrific crimes hidden under a clown mask, with this likely being one of those cases. It's clear the person in the costume is actually trying to break into the house with a knife.
Dude, he's just walking around the whole house.
After being unsuccessful, the clown would eventually walk off, and despite a police report, that would be the end of it. Ultimately, the homeowner would be left with nothing but this disturbing footage.
And did he say that all happened when the homeowner was asleep? Imagine not even knowing that that's happening, literally, you know, a couple feet away from you. That is, gives me the chills.
This footage was captured in Colorado.
Hey,
in the
Colorado.
Middle of the night. The issue, three mountain lions appearing from the darkness and starting to walk around a set of houses. They were captured even going as far as to walk up onto the porch of one of the houses.
Damn.
Mountain lion sightings are known to be exceptionally rare in this specific area. Typically, they'll stay a lot further in the mountains where they have easier access to the deer that they prey on. To see them in an area with a lot of people, especially in the neighborhood, is not at all common, at least in this area.
Those are some skinwalkers.
The three cans would eventually walk off, but there are almost no doubt things would have gone differently had one of these homeowners left their pets outside for the night. or possibly were even outside themselves.
I live in Colorado and I've never seen a mountain lion, but I mean, I also live like, actually I live like 30 minutes away from the mountains, but I'm like an hour and a half away from like the bigger mountains. That's probably where like more mountain lions are. There's a lot of foxes in my neighborhood. There's a lot of foxes, raccoons. That's about it. I see a deer here every once in a while.
This doorbell camera footage was captured in Overland Park, KS, in March of 2017. Shown in the video is a nearby active house fire.
Oh.
The home of the neighborhood just across the street has been completely engulfed in flames.
Wow.
As the fire department arrives, neighbors can be seen desperately moving their parked cars away from the house.
That's terrifying. Oh my gosh. That's insane. Could you imagine being like the people who live in this house and looking across the street and seeing that? I don't know.
Eventually, a flaming piece of debris can be seen falling and landing on a set of bushes just in front of the camera.
Oh. Don't tell me this house is going to catch on fire too. Wow, debris? Really? I guess I didn't know that. I maybe from the wind and stuff, I guess.
The bushes quickly burst into flames. The fire starts spreading quickly, but before it's able to get out of hand, a neighbor notices it and attempts to put it out.
Oh, wow.
He grabs a garden hose and sprays the fire while pressing the house's doorbell. However, the owner of the house isn't home and frantically tries to communicate this through the doorbell
speaker. What a good neighbor, though. Great neighbor right there. Noticing that and doing, and look at all them coming together and doing that. That's awesome. Wait. He said your house is on fire. Is it the bushes that are on fire? Or is it the whole house?
The fire department would be able to put out the house fire.
That's good.
And with help from the neighbors, prevent it from spreading to nearby houses.
That's good. Okay, I was about to say, I thought like more houses were going to catch on fire. And I was going to be like, ain't no way.
This video was posted by Doordell News in September of 2022. This video shows a man knocking on the door at 3 a.m. He pounds on the door multiple times. This guy needs some help, but it's 3 in the morning and he needs to go away. He asks the homeowner to come to the door and talk to him.
What? Nah, never open the door past like 9 o'clock. If someone's...
There was no reply from the homeowner. The guy went into the street and started looking for a lift. Then he comes again and starts pounding on the door. He gets aggressive and starts yelling. The homeowner called the police. I don't know what he was looking for.
Oh my gosh, bizarre
behavior.
He's screaming, help me. Hell, he needs help, maybe. I don't know. Like I was saying, though, if someone's ringing your doorbell and knocking on your door past 9 p.m., it's probably not anything good. Even if it's like a neighbor knocking on your door, like you still know something bad happened. More than likely, of course.
Historical footage was recorded just before 4 o'clock a.m. on a night in August 2020. The video captures an unidentified man walking in front of a house and emptying the gas container over the yard.
Why does his head look so long?
Shortly after he disappears off screen,
he's wearing a mask.
Fire erupts just in front of the camera.
What? Dude, who would do that? Oh, nah. Nope, nope, nope.
No one would be injured during the incident, however. Unfortunately, two houses and a vehicle would be damaged.
Like what?
The homeowner would claim to have no idea who could be responsible or who would even consider doing this to them.
This is just some random guy.
At least from an outside perspective, the act looks completely random with seemingly no reason behind it.
What?
Making the clip all the more unsettling.
Yeah, that's pretty scary. God, I couldn't even imagine.
On a night in September of 2021, a homeowner would get a suspicious knock on his door at about 3 o'clock in the morning.
The people with the masks.
Upon opening his phone and looking at his doorbell camera, he would see two would look like teenagers identifying themselves as CPD or Columbus Police Department.
What? They don't think the camera can see them. That's funny. Oh, he has a firearm as well. Yep.
CPD, open up. We need to ask you a couple questions.
Are you kidding me?
The video shows the man in the front clearly holding a firearm, and the house sitter would eventually access the Doordal camera speaker to further question him.
There's a house sitter there at the time.
Can I help you? CPD, we need to ask you a couple questions. I'm sorry? CPD, we need to ask you a couple questions. May you please step to the front door, please?
They know there's a camera there, though.
Yes, this is CPD. We would like you to step to the door, please.
I guess they just think that the...
Can I see a badge? We would like you to step to the door, please, sir.
Oh, my.
The man refuses to show a badge.
Well, obviously, because he's not CPD.
Obviously, he doesn't have one. The homeowner knew what was going on, so rather than stepping to the door, he would call the real police department and report two armed men at his front door.
Yeah, I would have just kept talking to them until the police got there.
The two would once again attempt to get the homeowner to open the door. But after that failed, and they would run off before the real police could show up.
Dang. Unfortunate. Unfortunate.
CPD, open the door.
How dumb could you be? It's literally a camera looking right at you.
The two were most likely just looking to rob the man when he opened the door.
Yep.
But I mean, it's possible they had worse intentions in mind.
True.
There's just
very true.
No way of knowing for sure. Both of them were never identified by police.
It's so unfortunate. Like, a lot of these people who are trying to rob people, they just never get caught. They probably, to this day, are continuing to do this. Like, it's scary. And think about all the people who don't have doorbell cameras. Get yourself a doorbell cam. Lock your doors.
In May of 2018, a woman would leave her parts car that was just outside her house unlocked overnight. Not surprisingly, someone would find the unlocked car.
Why would you not lock your car?
And proceed to steal multiple items that were owned by the woman.
Come on,
guys. A few hours later, the man responsible for the theft would be caught on the woman's doorbell camera, attempting to use her set of keys that he had just stolen to unlock her house's front door.
Oh. Wow. I actually had a neighbor up the street pretty recently, like in the last like 2 months. They left their garage open overnight, and someone went in the garage and stole their car because their keys were in their car. And
this all took place while the house owner was home and sleeping.
Took it.
But luckily, the set of keys he had stolen didn't have a house key on it, so the guy just ended up walking off. Had the set of keys contained a house key, things most likely would have ended much differently.
Yeah.
Shown in this Doordal camera footage is an unknown man wearing an oddly disturbing mask. As he walks up to the door,
his emotions
alert the camera to start recording. And that's when you can see him grab the door handle, realize it's locked, and hesitantly knock on the door.
Oh. Dude, is that a mask? I can't tell if it's a mask or if it's just him sitting there and smiling. I think it is a mask, yeah.
The man would wait for only a few seconds before he would pull his sleeve over his hand and wipe off his fingerprints from the door handle before walking off.
Wow. You're gonna do all that, but you're not gonna wear gloves? Come on now.
Around a minute later, the homeowner would come to the door and now see the man across the street sitting in a car. When she yelled down to him to see what he wanted, he would quickly speed off.
Oh.
The homeowner would later state that she had no idea who this man could have been or what he was doing there. The fact that he removed his own fingerprints from the door handle suggests that he had most likely given them to the police at some
point. Yeah, I was about to say.
It's not completely unreasonable to conclude that this man had some sort of criminal record.
Yeah, I was literally
something
just going to say
note
that.
Is that someone's heavy object can be seen weighing down his
front
pocket.
Oh, true.
It's not clear what this is. And
probably a firearm.
It's not clear who this man is.
Firearm or knife or something.
Make it impossible for police to identify both the man's identity and his intentions.
Wow.
In July of 2021, Amanda Nowick updated her Facebook with an alarming video. She took this video from her Ring doorbell as she set in for sleep. Someone rang her doorbell. She checked the app, only to see a man with gray hair and a full-grown gray beard presently knocking on her door and ringing the bell. Amanda didn't recognize this man, so she ignored the knocking, but the stranger didn't leave.
Oh, dude.
As well as knocking, he kept repeating he wanted to talk to her and had questions for her.
No.
Are you sure? I just rang your doorbell because I have a couple questions for you.
Is that his real voice? I think he's tweaked out.
Are you sure? I just rang your doorbell because I have a couple questions.
Oh yeah, he is tweaked out.
Are you sure? Are you sure? I just rang your doorbell because I have a couple questions for you.
Dude, he's just repeating the same exact thing. That is so scary.
Are you sure?
Yeah, he is definitely tweaked out.
Positive? Are you sure?
Oh, he's reaching for the door.
When she was home alone, she called her husband to tell him what was happening and called 911. So Amanda's husband accessed the camera from his phone and saw the man. Ignoring him wasn't doing the trick, so he decided to talk to him using the speaker.
Who are you?
What?
I'm having a conversation with this guy?
Are you sure? Who are you?
Hey, I just had a couple questions and I just wanted to ask you about the baby tool. Yeah, can you hear me? What I'm looking for is for the girl that's in the house to come
out
here.
Oh, hell no. What? 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 Nah, this fool is tweaked out.
After threatening the woman in a stone-cold tone,
this guy needs to be sent to prison for the rest of his life.
He just leaves. As the man calmly walks away,
he
continues to talk to himself down the street.
No, he is for sure tweaked out. Come on now. Wow, I did not see that coming. Dude, he's still saying it. Maybe like schizophrenic or something like that.
Amanda was terrified, but she feared this man might move to another house and hurt someone.
Mm-hmm.
So she took the creepy footage and posted it on Facebook.
Wow.
And it was thanks to this post that this man was arrested.
Heck yeah. That's what I was about to say. That dude needs to be in prison for the rest of his life. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you guys did enjoy, please be sure to leave a like and subscribe, post notifications on. And without further ado, I will see you guys in the next video. Have a great rest of your day and peace out.